In the energy quadrant today, taking a look at the March natural gas futures contract, which was down 12.45% on the lows today. That low was 4.816, and after a 15.8% rally yesterday, that entire move got reversed during the course of the day. NASDAQ was up over 20% this week, but is now only up about 6.6%, most of which is made up from the gap from the close of January 28th to the open on Monday, January 31st. That gap makes up most of what we're up on the week today. A little bit from the recovery that we got today, finishing down only about 6%. But the high today is 5.454, was a gap from yesterday's settlement down about 85 basis points. The low 4.816 was down 12.45%, as I mentioned. EIA report came out today and printed a draw of 268 billion cubic feet, which was slightly larger of the estimates of about 275 to 279 billion cubic feet, but much larger than the five-year average of 150 billion cubic feet. The natural gas deficit is now larger, sitting at 143 billion cubic feet, jumping from 25 billion cubic feet last week, that's the deficit, and decreased supplies to 2.32 trillion cubic feet. Now, weather demand is high right now. It's going to be very high through the weekend and then moderate mid next week. A huge winter storm is going to dive into Texas and areas of the south, bringing ice, snow, and low temperatures of 0 degrees to 30 degrees, while it remains dangerously cold over the Midwest with lows of minus 20 degrees to highs of plus 10 degrees. That's cold. The Arctic front is going to gradually move east this weekend, but lose strength in the process. But still, it's going to be cold, just not as cold as it was over the Midwest. Then a mild break's expected over much of the U.S. from the middle to the end of next week, with highs of 40 degrees to 70 degrees as you move south, and that'll drop demand. The northern U.S. near the border with Canada will still be in the 20 to 30 range. Most of the rest of the U.S. will be mild.